Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. In this video, we will learn how to use the replace objects feature as a way to initialize your pick and place station by repositioning all the objects at predefined position. Let's jump right into it. Once again, we use this basic pick and place station as an example. Our goal would be to record the position of the box here in a way that if either at the end of the program or during the process, I want to replace my box at its original position, I don't need to revert back to the small notepad tricks by copying the position and then repasting it on the object. So there's a way to pretty much take a screenshot or a snapshot of where all the objects in your station are and revert back to that state whenever you want. So that's what we call replace object. To reach that feature, you need to create a new program. So let's create a new program and I will call it replace objects, just like that. I then need to add a simulation event. So let's select this one. And in under action, I will select either set object position absolute or set object position relative. I would say that in 95% of the times, set object position relative is the one you're looking for. We'll discuss the other one later. So here, if you select this one, what's inside the list here, the list box, is a bit different. You won't have access to all the objects and all the frame. So for now, I will only select both of the objects here, the table and the box. If I click OK, you will see that the new simulation event appear here and it's called replace objects. So the use of this one is the following. So if I just run the pick a program, select, I'm going in and I'm picking the object and I want to, let's say, bring it back to the original position to test it again. So what I can do is simply select here, replace objects. And here the object is back exactly where it was. And it's also under the same parent it was when it was recorded. Same goes for if you move the object manually. So let's say if I bring the object to 500 like that here and 250 here, if I select replace object, it will go back to its original position. So very handy. Another thing that I can do, let's move that here to a given position, or why not with a specific orientation. This will also be fixed. And I could do the same with the table, double click the table here, and I don't know, move it to 1000 like that and minus 5000. So it's really like completely out of the screen. It's right here. As I recorded or saved both object positions, when I went for modify and selected those two here, I don't want to do it again, otherwise it would save the position. If I click replace object, everything goes back to its original position, including the box and the table. So everything was bring back to its original position. If I want to record a new position here, I can either go back here, modify, right click modify, and then reselect the objects and click OK. That would save the new position. Or I can, let's move the table just a bit like that so that the objects are just near the edge here. So what I can do is right click replace object and then record all objects. If I do that, even if I move this back to, I don't know, -2, if I replace object, it will go back to the newly recorded position here. So I will save it once again with 0. So right click and record all objects. It will take a snapshot of all the objects that were selected in this feature here. So that's super handy. I would generally do that before I even do one motion. So I will place all my objects and then I will kind of take my snapshot of the object positions. And then I will start creating my step-by-step pick. So this way I can test it out way faster because I don't need to have a full loop to test it out. I can just go pick the first object as soon as it's in my gripper and I'm satisfied with it. I can simply replace, run it again, replace, run it again as many times as I want. I can even add this replace object to a normal program. So let's say in our main here, if we remove the call for place B and we change call pick B, so right click, modify, and here instead of pick B, I will go and select replace objects, click OK. And if I do that here, you will see that I pick in here, move it here, and then it will go back to its original position automatically, because that calls the reset. So instead, what I would generally do is have it at the beginning here. Let's say this is not a loop. So this way I call it, it's kind of initialized at the right spot, and then I can run it like this. So very handy. In the station, I showed you here the organized box. The first station I had, I have a replace object. This is what will bring back the object wherever I want at the original spot. So here, if I move, let's say two boxes and I'm done, I press escape to stop that here and I can select replace object and all the objects will go back to their original position. And if I run it, you can see here, I have it as a replace object. I have the replace object here as an init of this program. So even if I stop here, even if I don't double click it manually, I can simply launch the main program and everything will go back to its original position. And then the program can start once again. So personally, replace object is part of almost all the project or station I build. I think it's a big time saver and very cool, so that you can just send your station to someone with just the press on main or run the main and everything will be set up exactly like it was supposed to. As I told you before, there's also the, like I said, the relative. Here, if we go back to the original here, right click, modify, you should generally use the set object position relative. So this will let you move the reference frame around. So if I move here, the reference frame to this position here, which I might want to do, and if I click replace object, oh, here, this was recorded in this spot. So I need to, let's say, move this one here. And if I move that like this here, and then replace object, it will be positioned at the same spot relative to the reference frame where it was saved. So that's the big difference. Otherwise, if it was absolute, it would remember where the object was in the station and it would put back the object where it was in the station, but not necessarily relative to the reference frame that it's directly attached to, just with respect to the station origin. So that will give you something like that. Let's say if you have the object here, right click, modify, and here I select set object position absolute, I click OK, and then I move this reference frame, I don't know, here, and then replace object. It won't follow the reference frame. It will go back to the absolute position where it was recorded. So that's a big difference. So that's why I'm saying most of the time you will use relative, because you want to have the flexibility to move your frames around, because all the parts are generally attached to that frame, but you want to be able to reposition those objects with respect to that main frame that you're working in. So to give you another example here, if I bring back my box organizer, I have that frame here. So I want to be able to, even if I move the frame around because I decided that in fact I need to, this tray will be here, and if I want to replace object, all the objects will be repositioned properly with respect to that reference frame here because I used the relative option. Okay, so that's pretty much everything for this video. In the next one, we will talk about the different options you have when you do a pick application. So right click, modify here. You have different options here. We will cover those because they are very useful. And if you don't understand them properly, you might think you have some bugs in your program that aren't there, in fact. So I do believe that if you are interested in pick and place applications, you should really not miss the next video that is coming. Okay, that being said, have a great day, guys.